treated by nothing but warmth and kindness from Detroiters in every neighborhood of the city. I am just so appreciative. I can't stop for gas or go into a store without somebody coming up, smiling, wanting their picture taken, and then they want to know when I'm going to get the dead tree down in front of their house. And I say, that's Detroit. That's what we're working so hard for. And we started out, we had to decide what kind of campaign we're going to run. And after you watch what happened nationally, and this is a decision, because I had resources, and were we going to run the kind of campaign where we were going to trash our opponent, or were we going to spend the time talking about the vision for what we're still going to do in the next 4 years? And I thought one of the most profound things President Obama ever said was, if you have to divide people in order to get elected, you'll never be able to govern. All right, we're seeing that. And so we made a decision that with all of the us versus them attacks, I decided I didn't care. I wasn't going to respond to it. And I'm very proud of the fact that at the end of this campaign, we did not spend one dime on TV, radio, or mail attacking our opponent. And I hope that this is the year where we put us versus them politics behind us forever, because we believe in one Detroit for all of us.
Heading the right direction.
because of the job that the men and women in the city and the police and the fire department and the inspection department and the housing department all across the city. And I just want to say to you that city government is going to stay in the hands of a strong financial management team. And to those 9,000 employees, you can enjoy this holiday. No one's going to be talking about cutting your pay, cutting your health, cutting your pension. And finally, to the outstanding management team, our cabinet, the best of Detroit and the best of America that have come together, led by Alexis Wiley and Dave Masseron. Dave Masseron and the Deputy Mayor and Police Chief, James Critter. So the Chief Greg is glad that he knows he still has his job. And so, to the Cabinet, I'm going to say to you what you would expect. Cabinet meeting.